Hello students, myself Mrs. Chetna Patel from LP Samani Group of School. Now in this particular session, we are going to start with chapter 2, Nelson Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. Long walk here means struggle to freedom there, okay? The struggle which was been started by his ancestor, and fortunate enough, the freedom was achieved during his time there, okay? Now this particular chapter is based on one particular word, and the word is apartheid. As you can see, the first word before you read, apartheid. Now what is that apartheid? Apartheid is a political system that separates people according to their race, okay? In a more simpler words, discrimination on the basis of color, caste, creed, and religion. Now, this is not something new, and we have many illustrations in our past also, where the people have been discriminated on the basis of color, caste, creed, or religion. Okay? Now, in the ancient time, the society was divided into four classes. Where the upper class were the Brahmins, the second were Kshatriyas, the third were the Vaishyas, and the fourth class were Shudras. Shudras, people belonging to lower caste, and they were treated and they were considered as slaves. And they were said to be born to serve the people from the upper class there. Okay, so this is the first thing. Second, practice of untouchability. History is a witness there, where the Harijans and the people belonging to the lower caste were considered as untouchables, where they were not given equal opportunities as others. They were asked to live at the outskirts of the town or a country. They were not allowed to draw water from the well. They did not have many other equal opportunities and all. Then there is also an incident about Mahatma Gandhi, who was once traveling to South Africa, and he was traveling in a first class compartment, where he was being thrown out of the compartment by the white people, saying that the first class compartment is meant only for the white people. And talking about the more recent event in New York, that is in America, where the black African American was being killed by the four cops. You remember George Floyd, who was being killed by the four cops, and which gave rise to the riots in America, and rather the whole America was set on fire. So though we say that such things does not exist or prevalent there, but no, still it has been practiced. Maybe that has not been shown, or still it has been practiced, where the white people still have that feeling of hatred towards the black people. Okay, so this particular chapter is also an autobiography of Nelson Mandela, a person who fought for his own race of people, for the black Africans, and considered as a mainstream of the society. Okay, now before you read, we'll go with that. Apartheid is a political system that separates people according to their race. Okay, so here the three options are given, where it was being practiced. Till recently, it was practiced in South Africa. Moving on to the second point. Have you heard of Nelson Mandela? Mandela and his African National Congress spent a lifetime fighting against apartheid. Mandela had to spend 30 years in prison. Finally, democratic elections were held in South Africa in 1994, and Mandela became the first black president of a new nation. Okay, now in this extract from this autobiography, Long Walk to Freedom, Mandela speaks about a historic occasion, the inauguration. Okay, so this particular chapter, it's an inauguration when Mandela became the first South African president there. Okay, so here we have the introduction in the box there. Okay, I'll read that. Nelson Mandela had become the South African first black president after more than 3 centuries of white rule. 3 centuries, almost 300 years. Mr. Mandela's African National Congress, this is a party been formed by him, won 252 votes of the 400 seats in the first democratic election of South African history. The inauguration ceremony took place in the Union Building Amphitheatre in Pretoria today. It's the capital of South Africa, which was been attended by politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries around the world. Never, never again will this beautiful land experience the oppression of one by another, said Nelson Mandela in his address. Jubilant scenes on the streets of Pretoria followed the ceremony, with the blacks, white and coloured celebrating together. More than 100,000 South African men, women and children of all the races sang and danced with joy. Okay, now after the introduction, we'll continue over here. Now as you can see over here, there's an activity where you have to match the following there, okay? In column A, some expressions are given, okay? So do this activity after hearing the video. The phrases which you are going to come across, they are all from the chapter. So if you do this exercise, it will enhance you for the better understanding there, okay? Now let me start with the chapter there. Fine. 10th May dawned bright and clear. Dawn, we say, no, from dawn to dusk. Dawn means early in the morning, in the wee hours, okay? For the past few days, I had been pleasantly besieged by dignitaries. Besieged means be surrounded closely by or been asked by dignitaries, having the high profile there, okay? So, status. And the world leaders who were coming to pay their respect before the inauguration, okay? So, the day when the inauguration was going to take place, so Nelson Mandela was being surrounded by the dignitaries. They were coming to pay the respect, okay? And not only that, but they were even congratulating him. See, now, he had won, or he was been elected on a fair basis. There was no bias, okay? His party, African National Congress, where the voting took place, the party won 252 votes out of 400. So everything was on a fair basis. The inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leader on the South African soil, okay? So this was the first time where the dignitaries from all around the world have landed on this South African soil there, okay? So it was a great honor for the, not only the president Nelson Mandela, but the people belonging to his race, okay? Now the second paragraph is all about where the ceremony took place. The ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater. Amphitheater, it's a building without a roof with many rows of seats rising in steps of, it's a typical ancient Greece and Rome, okay? Like how we have a stadium in a similar way, okay? Formed by the Union Buildings in Pretoria. For decades, this had been the seat of a white supremacy, and now it was the site of a rainbow gathering of different colors and nations for the installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government, okay? So this particular area, as it has been said over here, it has been the seat of a white supremacy almost for 3 decades. Okay, so only the white people would appear over here. But this was the first time. It was a site of a rainbow gathering. Rainbow gathering means a beautiful coming together of various people, like the colors in a rainbow there. Okay, so they have all come together for the first time. And for the first time on the South African soil, it was a democratic, non-racial government where the people were not discriminated on the basis of the color there. Okay, so it was a real proud and a honorable moment for all the black Africans here, present over here. Okay, I hope it's clear till here. Okay, so after the results of the elections, on the day of inauguration, all of you know that whether it's a president, prime minister, what they do the next thing during the day of inauguration, they take an oath. Okay, so here also we are going to see when it was a time for him to take an oath, who were present along with him on the podium there. Okay, so on that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Zenani. Okay, and so he was accompanied by his daughter Zenani. On the podium, there were a few other people. Who are they? That is Mr. D. Clark was the first sworn is as the second deputy president. Okay, so another person present on the podium was Mr. D. Clark, who was been selected as a second deputy president there. Okay, okay. Now before I move further, just try to understand the first on that lovely autumn day. Now see, the inauguration took place on 10th May. May, it's a time, it's a summer time. Okay, but then too it is said to be as a lovely autumn. Now why it is said to be a lovely autumn? Because see, literally as well as symbolically, what happens in autumn? Tree leave old and rotten leaves, and after that new leaves with the fresh colors are born. So symbolically, the old and the rotten system of apartheid was coming to an end, and a new republic based on equality of men, color and races was taking birth on 10th May during the autumn, and that is why it is said to be as lovely autumn day. Okay, so clear with that? Fine. So Zenani, his daughter, Mr. D. Clark, who was as a second deputy president. Okay, here you can see the beautiful pic of Nelson Mandela. Okay, now along with D. Clark and Zenani, there was another person named Thabo Mbeki was sworn it as a first deputy president. Okay, so these were the two person who are going to take an oath first, and then it was Nelson Mandela's turn there. Okay, when it was my turn, I pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people. To the assembled guests and the watching world, I said. Okay, the next rest of the thing you'll see, that was a speech been given by Nelson Mandela. Okay, today all of us do by our presence here confer glory and hope to the newborn liberty out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster that lasted too long. Must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud. We who are outlaw not so long ago have today been given the rare privilege to be the host to the nations of the world on our own soil. We thank all of our distinguished international guests for having come to take positions with the people of our country, of what it is. After all, a common victory for justice, for peace, and for human dignity. Okay? Confer here means to give. Okay? And those who were outlaws. Outlaws here means Because of its policy of apartheid, many countries had earlier broken off diplomatic relations with the South Africa there. Okay, so what he's trying to say is here, Mandela spoke that how for decades South Africa was a seat of white supremacy, and now the presence of all the people confer glory, that is a victory, okay, and a hope to a newborn liberty. Liberty here means freedom, okay. So, and this was the first time where the black Africans, who were considered as outlaw, who were not regarded in as a mainstream, was so long ago, were hosting the nation of the world on their soil there, okay. So this was the first time when they had the privilege to host, okay. And it was the first time where the people from all over 140 countries, all the dignitaries, were present on the soil of Africa. Okay, let us continue what he said further in his speech. We have at last achieved our political emancipation. Okay, now what does emancipation means? Freedom from restrictions, where the South Africans were being restricted in all the areas. Okay, fine. So moving further. We pledge ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty, deprivation, suffering, gender bias, and other discrimination. Deprivation, state of not having one rightful benefits, and discrimination, being treated differently or unfavorably. Okay, so here all these things are my race people, that is a South African blacks, were free now. They are not going to be under the bondage of poverty. They are not going to be deprived of anything. They do not have to suffer gender bias. At the same time, they will not be discriminated on the basis of the color there. Okay? Never, never, and never again shall it be that this beautiful land will again experience the operation of one by another. Okay, so he's emphasizing that never, never it is going to happen now that the white people are going to oppress the black Africans there. Okay, so here it is an end of an apartheid. Okay, the sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Let freedom reign, and God bless Africa. Okay, so here he's talking about their victory over apartheid was a common victory for justice, peace, and human dignity. Political freedom had been won, okay, by the black Africans. Now they would work hard to liberate all their people from the bondage of poverty, deprivation, and disease. Okay, and that is why he's emphasizing that never now South African, that is a black South African, will face the operation of one by another there on the soil of South Africa. Okay, and that is how he is also blessing all the Africans over here. Fine. Okay, now here we complete the quarter part of the chapter. Okay, so this will be the first part. Then we'll continue in the next session there. Okay, that's all.